Good morning, children. Welcome back to our self-development class, Chapter 3, Visual Arts and Art. In today's session, we will cover up some Indian painters and their art. Our Indian painters are really very creative and innovative. Some of them, in fact, most of them, have been trained in the Western tradition in painting, in arts, in sculptures, but how they have innovative ideas of them has proved them internationally as honorable. They have received many awards. You can read the textbook and you can know there are only few painters here in your text, children, but if you go to find out, there are many more painters in our country who are well known for their arts, who have been trying with their brushes and creating art out of it. So we'll check it out, all those. In our last class, I already explained to you all what is visual arts. Visual arts, we are using our vision to see them, to feel them and to create them. So if you are a person who is seeing and appreciating, so you are using your eyes. The painter as well is using his eyes. Of course, there are few exceptional who are not visually clear enough. They are impaired, but still they are very good in their arts. So you can see here how beautifully it is done. You can see that? A flower and a butterfly. Simple drawing, simple art, but there are sometimes there's a lot of meaning to it, and sometimes it's just an enrichment of an art to be appreciated and to feel at ease. So some Indian painters, children, in our textbook, just as we got ourselves introduced to the world famous styles and artists, let us now look at some Indian artists. So the first one in your text is Jamini Roy, born 1887, passed away 1972. Jamini Roy, children, he was born on 14th April 1887, Bilyatur, Bankura district. It comes in West Bengal. He passed away 24th April 1972, aged 85 years. Nationality, of course, Indian, known for painting and notable work, he is a painter. Awards Padma Bhushan in 1954. Jamini Roy, 11th April 1887, as I said before, he was an Indian painter. He was honored with the State Award of Padma Bhushan in 1955. That is 54-55. He was one of the most famous pupils, pupil means student, of Abhindranath Tagore, whose artistic originality and contribution to the emergence of art in India remains questionable. Jamini Roy, he was born into a moderately prosperous Kavastya family. Kavastya family of landowners in Bilyatur village of the Bankura district. Landowners, you know, Jamindars. He was raised in an average middle class, art loving household, which ultimately influenced his future decisions. When he was 16, he was sent to study at the Government College of Art, Kolkata. Abhindranath Tagore, the founder of Bengal School, was vice principal at the institution. He was taught to paint in the prevailing academic tradition, drawing classical nudes and painting in oils, and in 1908 he received his diploma in fine art. However, he soon realized that he needed to draw inspiration not from Western traditions but from his own culture, and so he looked to the living folk and tribal art for inspiration. Living folk, living human beings. He was most influenced by the Kali Ghat, but Okay, that's Kalighat painting, which was a style of art with bold sweeping brush strokes. He moved away from his earlier impressionist landscapes and portraits, and between 1921 and 1924 began his first period of experimentation with the Santal dance as his starting point. Jamini Roy had 4 sons and 1 daughter, just to know about his family. Kalighat painting is this way, children. You can see this barber cleaning the woman's ear. Kalighat painting or Kalighat Pat originated in the 19th century in West Bengal. In the vicinity of Kalighat, Kali Temple, that's why the name is Kalighat, Calcutta, India, and from being items of souvenir taken by the visitors to the Kali Temple. The paintings over a period of time developed as a distinct school of Indian painting. From the depiction of Hindu gods, God and other mythological characters, the Kalighat paintings developed to reflect a variety of subjects, including many depictions of everyday life. So first it was only the paintings of God, goddesses, okay, and mythological or mythological, as you can say, those characters. But later on, they involved even the everyday life, the routine life of people around them. You can see this. Goddess Parvati with Lord Ganesh, baby Ganesh. This is how it is drawn. You can see painting. An important achievement of the Kalighat artists was that they made simple paintings and drawings which could easily be reproduced by lithography. Such prints were then hand colored, just like how you did it in school till the 8th standard. This trend continued up to the early part of the 20th century, and these paintings ended up in museums and private collections. The charm of the Kalighat paintings lies in the fact that they captured the essence of daily life, and they influence modern artists like the late Jamini Roy even to this day. These are the paintings from your textbook, children. You should Google out and check out all his paintings, lovely paintings. Also informations. Now next is Ram Kinkar Baig, 1906 to 1980, a sculptor. You can see sculptures. Okay. Milkol, Santal family. You just heard it in Jamini Roy, right? Santal. So here you can see. So Ram Kinkar Baig, children. Here is his photograph. You can see here. Born 25th May 1906. Bankura town. You just heard it in Jamini Roy. Bankura district, Bengal, British India, present day West Bengal. He was born 2nd August 1980, aged 74. Sorry, he passed away 2nd August 1980 at the age of 74. Extremely sorry for that. Nationality, Indian, known for sculptor, painter. He was a painter as well as sculptor, but he was well known for his all sculpting arts. Notable work: Lady with Dog, Sujata, Santal Family, Milkol, Joko Joki, Yaksha Yakshi. Movement Contextual Modernism. He also got award Padma Bhushan in 1970. Baig was born in an economically modest family in the Bankura district of the modern state of West Bengal in India. In that sense, he was a Bengali, not an Adivasi, as many people usually think. The way he looks, people thought he was an Adivasi. The surname Baig derived from Boida, Baidya, and Boigo. Anything you can pronounce because it's a proper noun. Consequently, his family surname was Poramanik and was abandoned by him in the early 1925. Abandoned means he gave up that surname. However, many of his artistic creations have been inspired by the lifestyles of rural Dalit or Adivasi, that is Santal communities, living in and around his place of work, Santi Niketan, that is Shanti Niketan at present. While in his mid-teens, Ram Kinkar used to paint portraits of Indian freedom fighters involved in the non-cooperation movement against the British rulers of India. At the age of 16, he got noticed by the renowned journalist Ramananda Chatterjee. 4 years later, Ram Kinkar joined the Viswa Bharati University at Santiniketan as a student of fine arts. After obtaining a diploma from the university, he went on to head the sculpture department. Ram Kinkar's renowned sculptor disciples include Prabhas Sen, Shanko Chaudhary, Avtar Singh Panwar, Madan Bhatnagar Dharmani, Balbir Singh Kutt, Rajul Dharial and Suzan Ghosh. So these are the disciples. Next is Narayan Sridhar Bendre. Not very clear pick of his. He was born 21st August 1910, Indore, Madhya Pradesh, British India. He passed away 19 February 1992 at the age of 81, Mumbai, Maharashtra. Nationality Indian, other names N.S. Bendre in short. Awards Padma Bhushan in 1992 and Padma Shri in 1969. These are his work. You can see common daily routines. You can see this one lady washing hair or cleaning or combing or whatever you can make out. And the others here you can see on the mountains. So it's a daily, everyday life is being depicted. Narayan Sridhar Bendre was in a Deshasta Rigvedi Brahmin family. On 21st August 1910, he was born in Indore, Madhya Pradesh. He was initially trained in the state art school there prior to taking the government diploma in art from Bombay in 1933. His initial interests were conditioned by the quasi modernist landscape painting as practiced in the Indore school at the beginning of the 20th century. An avid traveler, he was a traveler. Bendre continued to paint the landscape throughout his career, often with different stylistic means. Early recognition came with the silver medal from the Bombay Art Society in 1934, followed by the then ultimate honor of gold medal in 1941. Part of 1945 was spent as artist in residence at Santiniketan, where he met Nandalal Bose, Ram Kinkar Baig, and Binod Bihari Mukherjee. He also met Jamini Roy in Calcutta. Bendre's early work has been classified as being academic and impressionist, dominant subjects being the landscape and the portrait in oils and gouge. Look at his paintings, children. Lovely, beautiful, right? And just the routine. Here you can see this lady, she's reading a book. And here they are in leisure time. Then comes Dinanath Dalal. He was born 30th May 1916, passed away 15 January 1971. He was an Indian painter and illustrator. His works depicted various aspects of literature such as mythology, history, social issues, human emotions and politics. Here one of his art piece, you can see. Then comes Prabha. Born in 1933, Maharashtra, India, 2001. At the age of 67 and 68, she passed away, Nagpur, India. Indian Sir J.J. College of Art, which today also stands still. Known for painting, spouse, that is husband, Vittal. You can check her painting, children. Lovely, isn't that? Simple, but very, very impressionable. So that was her art. Reading out by about B. Prabha, children, because she was famous when there were not many of the women who took to art. Prabha completed her education in art from the J.J. School of Art, Mumbai. She started working at a time when not many artists were active in this field. She was highly influenced by Amrita Shergill, Most of Prabha's painting depict elongated, melancholy figures of rural women. A style of using only prominent color in painting can be seen in most of her paintings. She mostly created oil paintings. Her paintings depict women's social conditions, their hardships, their suffering, and their courage in the face of these odds. She often gave voice to women's suppressed feelings. I haven't seen a single happy woman. Can you believe that, children? She once said that in her paintings were selected for many exhibitions in and outside India because it was something real that was seen in her paintings. Now we will come across in our chapter that how this lady is handicapped. She cannot use her hand, so she's using her leg. But there is also art form where you have to use your legs, drawing with legs, painting with legs. You can see writing. This is one, children, drawing layers of objects. Begin with the floor, a bed sheet on top of it, a book kept on the bed sheet, or a teacup on the book, another book on top of it, a folded piece of cloth over it. Okay, you can try this at home. A newspaper on top of it, then a bucket over it, a plate on top of a cat sitting on the plate, etc. Whether to draw the objects realistically, example, if it is a cloth, it will be down from the sides, paper would stay straight up, or just as you please, is something for you to decide. It is okay even if you feel like creating a collage by sticking together pieces of paper. In such art pieces, it is possible to balance objects which would normally not balance each other. So that is also an art, children. Second, drawing with your feet. Hold your pencil or pen between your toes. You can also hold the pen or pencil between the heels of your feet. Try to hold the pencil in your mouth and draw. This, again, those who do not have hands and legs, you must have already heard in the news and you must have seen how they are using their mouth and creating beautiful artwork. Third, creating art from waste, best out of waste, which you have done. Try to make a face out of any form of waste. You can do this when you have time on your hands or need a break. Creating art using dust. Make a paper wet by sprinkling some water on it. Press it against the dust on the floor or cobwebs, spider's house. Try to see some picture that emerges out of it. Try to add to it by using your pen or pencil or colors to create something new. Fifth, creating using black color only. You must have seen my slides are black in color. Why many times people have some preconceived notions around the color black? Many people dislike this color. However, if used appropriately, it can look good. As or maybe better than other colors. So use your imagination. Can you create something using only black color and its shades? Find it out. Then next comes the planar geometry. Before that, you can see this is in a black painting, but it's looking beautiful. Sixth one is the planar geometry. Planar geometry itself tells you maths. Discuss about the methods to create different geometric shapes and also about where they can be found with the help of mathematics textbook. Sphere, something in round, children. And cube, cuboid, everything you know. Cube, it is square actually in a two dimension. So it's a cube in three dimension. And cuboid is rectangular in shape. And sphere is round in shape. And the seventh one is coloring therapy, which you must have already done. You keep mixing colors, right? Playing with colors. Therapy refers to a method of healing something. Art can also be used as therapy. Therapy means something healing children. Coloring therapy includes some designs which are pleasing to the eyes. These designs are intricate. Intricate means you can see lot of, you know, inside designs will be there. It is expected to color the designs as a part of the therapy. As your mind is engrossed in it, you tend to forget the stress. And this is philosophy of this therapy. Look at this design given below and complete it. So this is how the therapy works. See your children. This is called intricate designs and you have to color it. So while coloring it, you are forgetting your stress, whatever tension problems you are going to forget it. And thus it is a stress buster or therapy. Then comes field visit. We get to know about the lifestyle, culture, artistic vision of the ancient people by looking at the architecture of that period. Our understanding of art matures in this process. Buddhist caves are situated in the Ajanta mountain range, 60 miles north of Aurangabad. The Buddhist caves at Karle are known for their architecture. So arrange a field visit to an ancient architecture building in your area and note your observation. This is no need to be done because we have already visited so many places and you have already taken a note of it. What type of art do you like? This is a question for yourself, children. What type of art do you like? Art is a very subjective form of expression. Whatever is beautiful for one person need not be liked by the other. For example, somebody likes to do something best out of waste, and it's not necessary that you too will like it. Maybe you will like pot painting or you will like something else. Hence, it is not correct to classify art as good or bad. Just because we do not like a particular piece of art does not mean that it is not beautiful. Avoid labeling any artwork as good or bad. You can just explain why you liked or did not like a particular piece of art. So there is no good and bad. It is important to articulate why we like or do not like a piece of art. Articulate, you have to express. Trying to find out what we exactly like or not like in the drawing and trying to express it in words helps in developing our sense of art. We learn to see different aspects of beauty in the art piece. Next is career in the field of art, children. So you have to decide whether it's your passion or it's just a leisure time. So if it is a passion, then you got to pursue it as a career. Okay, even though you are good in studies, but it's your passion and you want to pursue it, so you have to go further. You have to know your dreams and you have to work towards it. So a career in visual art can begin either after 10th or 12th standard. After 10th, one can get admission to foundation or GD arts courses. So arts is a 4-year course after which one can study applied arts or fine arts. Diploma can also be done after 12th standard. In recent times, courses like sculpting, fashion designing, architecture, jewelry designing, animation, interior decoration, photography, etc. are also available, and not this much, children, there are much more. Okay, luxury and lot of things, luxury designing and many more sub branches have come up. So you can see more information can be seen on this given site, www.mahakareermitra. okay, you can just go on this site and you can find that, mitra.in. Some thoughts about art. Words fall short to explain the importance of art in human life. So there are many opinions, views and thoughts about art. How would you interpret the following statement about art? The aim of art is to clear the dust fallen on our minds in our daily life. Dust fallen on our minds, we need to think in a proper way, children. Dust fallen on our minds in our daily life. Because of daily life, we just start following one particular path. A painting is like a poem without words. Life is a canvas and you are the artist. So you write what you want to see in the future. Art enables us to find ourselves and lose ourselves at the same time. Every child is an artist Every child is an artist. Why children? Because you know, when we are small, we keep drawing on the wall, we draw with our legs. You know, actually every child is an artist. The problem is how to remain an artist once we grow up is all matters. See children, your self-development textbook, even this is an art. Okay? So this is how artistically you can decide for your future if you are inclined, if you have passion to go about it. So future hands hold, that is in the future is in your hands children. You can see this painting very beautifully done. You have to decide what you want to do and go for it. And also whether you are a painter or not, whether you like something or not, but be have an artistic eye. Okay, nothing can be good or bad, but it can be only like and dislike. Okay, if you like, you appreciate it, why you like, and if you dislike also, you reveal it, why do you dislike it, because your feedback helps that particular painter or artist to improve upon. So this is all about this chapter children, visual arts and I. We have completed this and we will be going on further for the next chapter in our next video children. Now two chapters are pending, so we will complete that soon. So visual arts and I is here, and you have to have an eye, you have to have a vision to appreciate arts. Thank you children, have a nice day.